Today we are going to be focusing on scatter plots and lines of fit. The vocabulary for the lesson is, what's a scatter plot? So a scatter plot is basically just a graph in which two sets of data are plotted as ordered pairs on a plane or on a graph. These are used to represent a relationship between two quantities. There are three types of scatter plots. There is either a positive correlation, a negative correlation, or there is no correlation. So, if there's a positive correlation, that basically means that there is going to be a positive slope. So, if you have all these points, and it looks like you could draw a line straight through them, and that is sloping upwards. Go from left to right, moving upwards. And then a negative slope is when you have these points, and it looks like it could make, if you draw a line in between them, go from left to right, sloping downwards. That's called a negative correlation. If there is no correlation, you just have dots just randomly all over the place. It doesn't look like it's going up. Doesn't look like it's has a line going up. Doesn't have a line. Doesn't look like it has a line going down. There's really no correlation. You are not able to draw a line whatsoever. For our last bit of vocabulary, we are going to be talking about the line of fit. Basically, what that is it is what the line that describes the trend of the data in the scatter plot. So, we have our data. It is a positive correlation from what we just previously learned because it's sloping upwards. What the line is, try to pick a line that goes in between of all of the points. By doing that, this right here, this is called the line of fit. It describes the trend of the data. So one of the main points of the lesson is to figure out how to actually write a line of data, write a line of fit from the data that they give you. So I have three steps for you. The first step is you need to make a scatter plot. They will give you the information in a table. So all that you have to do is to plot it at the x and y coordinates. So just all you have to do is just plot the points. Second thing, once you plot the points, step two, draw the line that seems to pass close to most of the data points. That would be called the line of fit. Step three, now we're actually going to write the line of fit. You take 2 points to write the equation. So you take any 2 points in the table. You find the slope of these points. Find the slope. It's important. Remember, the slope is the change of y over the change of x. Then you take 1 point and the slope, and you use y equals mx plus b to write the equation of the line. You use y equals mx plus b. You plug in the points for y and x. You use the slope, plug it in there, and then you solve for b. Once you figure it out, you would write y equals mx plus b, and that would be what the line is. Alright, in this example, we have on our x and y axis, we have height as the x axis and weight as the y axis. So what I want to do, I want to find the line of fit for this information. So remember, step one, graph it. Graph this information. Alright, so now we have our graph with our points. 62, 115, 63, 124, 65, 120, 67, 140, 68, 138, 69, 147. Now we have step two. Figure out, draw the line of fit. So now when we do this, remember we need to draw a line that fits closely in between all of the points. So it looks like it would be in between a little bit like that. So now we have step three. We need to find two points on this line that looks like that could possibly fall on the line. Remember, this is just an estimation. So it looks like it comes within the crosshairs right here at 64, 20. So I'm going to use this point. And let's see here. What's another one that's kind of close? It's not directly on this line, but it's close. I'm just going to use this point because it's semi-close, so I'm going to use it. So this point is 67, 40. I also use this point just because it's easy numbers to work with. So we have our points of 64, 120. And 67, 140. Now, remember, we have to find the slope. Find the slope is the change of y, which is 140 minus 120 over 67 minus 64. So 140 minus 120 is 20. 67 minus 64 is 3. Since it's a slope, I'm just going to leave it as a fraction. Just going to leave it as 20 over 3. So that is going to equal our m. Now, we have our m. Now remember, we're going to use the slope-intercept form, which is y equals mx plus b. I'm going to solve for B. By doing that, I'm going to pick one of these two points, and that's going to be my X and my Y. So I'm just going to plug it in, and I'll just use this one right here. So my Y is going to be 120. My M is 20 over 3. My X is 64. So by doing that, all that I have to do is solve for B. B is going to be my y-intercept where it crosses. So once I solve this through, 20 times 64 divided by 3 is equal to about 426 and a third plus B. 120 to get B by itself. I'm going to have to subtract 426. So 120 minus 426 is B is equal to negative 306. Now we have our M, we have our B. So once we solve this, put this in Y equals MX plus B form, we have Y is equal to 20 over 3x minus 306. This is kind of a little small area for me to work in, but this would be our final answer. So remember, we have to graph the information that we get up here, Step 2, find the line of fit. Just a little guesstimate. Remember, it's as you're just estimating. Step 3, find 2 points that are close to the line of fit. And then find the slope of those. Once you find the slope, you pick one of the points and you plug it in for the y equals mx plus b. So you have your points of 64, 120. Plug in the slope that you found, and that's your b. Put the m and the b together, and that will be your final answer. All right, quick little time for review. If we have our graph where the points are sloping upwards, this is a positive correlation. If we have points that are sloping downward, that is a negative correlation. If we have points that are kind of just all over the place and doesn't look like it that could form into a line, that means that there is no correlation. The steps when it comes to figuring out the line of best fit. Step 1. Graph the points. Step 2. Figure out your line of fit. Step 3. Find your points. Two points. Then figure out plug it into the y equals mx plus b equation.